Ross Dumfries and Galloway.
West Sound.
More hits music. West Sound.
Lockerbie. For many, every time they hear that name, one thing comes into their heads. Of that fateful day in December 1988 when a plane blew up over the town, killing everyone on board and 11 others on the ground. It was, and still is, the worst terrorist attack to ever happen on UK soil. For many others though, Lockerbie is the town they've spent 25 years trying to rebuild. Today we speak to those people about their memories of that day and how things have changed a quarter of a century on.
My name is Marjorie McQueen.
Okay, Margie, so can you tell us a bit about the day of the 21st of December before the explosion happened? Can you tell us what that day was like for you?
It was quite a busy day because it ran up to Christmas and I was having a lot of family here for Christmas. The house was going to be full, so I'd been doing some baking and freezing some stuff and done some shopping.
Well, on December 21st, 1988, I had asked my mother to come down to Lockerbie for Christmas. So I came up here to Ayrshire to Salkers to pick her up. And we travelled down to Lockerbie, arriving probably about 5 o'clock, maybe after 5 o'clock or so.
So my daughter and I had just sat down to watch television at 7 o'clock. And it was Harry Corbett of Sooty fame. It was Sooty's This Is Your Life. And I do remember a large Sooty coming onto the stage. And shortly after that, I heard a noise like thunder, just seemed to be a thunderstorm. But as thunder rolls in and then it rolls out again, this just kept coming and it got louder and louder.
And at 7 o'clock, it dawned on me that I'd left my mother's Christmas present upstairs in the room that she was going to be using in the cupboard. So I thought I'd better go up there and remove that. So I went up to where her bedroom would have been, and I opened up the cupboard and took out the present, which was a fireside rug. And I just laid in the bed, and I turned to close the cupboard door, and I heard the sound of a jet sort of hitting my roof.
So I actually went outside, and as I was standing outside at the back of the house, I was aware just of a shadow passing the house. And then when I was outside, there was just this noise, which wasn't, I wouldn't say it was an explosion, it was just like a sort of crump noise, and then the whole sky turned orange and flames and debris stuff just went up into the air, hundreds of feet into the air.
So I opened up the front door and the whole street had gone, really totally gone, fire and flame everywhere, and front garden was covered with bits and pieces. I don't know what it was. And I said to my mother, we'll have to get you up here. So I took my mother, I got her wrapped up and I told her, don't look at anything when you go, don't look at anything.
I think at that time, really thought that it was perhaps two trainer jets had collided or one of them had crashed in the town, because there had been a lot of low flying in Lockerbie. And it certainly wasn't till later on in the evening when my husband's partner got word back that he had gone up to Tundergarth, been ushered into the field in the car, and his headlights had picked out the nose cone of the Maid of the Seas, and that's when he let us know that actually This was huge.
People were asking me, you know, if I'd seen this person and that person, but I really couldn't say at the time. I could just say, I don't know. I really did believe, though, if anyone's still in there, they were gone.
In terms of the people of Lockerbie, do you think did everyone kind of pull together to work through it?
Oh, absolutely. The response to this was absolutely magnificent.
I think about Lockerbie every day, you know, of my life, but I don't. I think of the people I've known over the past years, I think of those who have died. I still feel a deep sorrow and sadness for them and what they came through. I feel a deep sense of pride, actually, in the people of Lockerbie and the way that they responded to the disaster. They were fantastic. Because after all, this was Christmas time, and they just cancelled their lives, really.
And I remember shortly afterwards, they asked for volunteers to help with various things. And I think from a town of a population of about 4,000, they had over 1,000 volunteers wanting to help. None of us wanted to sit at home and contemplate our navels about what had happened. We wanted to be out and helping and doing something.
Was there a point where kind of normal life did return?
Normal life returned, as far as I was concerned, very, very quickly. The houses were rebuilt in Sherwood Crescent. I think that was done in a really, really fast response. And I think that's what the town needed. And I remember people in cars winding down the window and asking where the hole was and this sort of thing, which was really quite insensitive. And it was a short time after that there was no hole. They got it all fixed. And within months, all that we really knew that had happened in Lockerbie would be a sign, you know, to say, pointed to the Garden of Remembrance. They got that up and to do that and the memorial stone as well. So Lockerbie returned very, very quickly to the same town it had been before. But of course the name's synonymous with disaster, so we can't help that.
In a sense, the people of Lockerbie have wanted to move on, which is understandable. But on the other hand, you know, I don't think it's really possible to move on totally from something like that which has happened to them, which has been so personal and so devastating. It will always be there for them, no matter what. I mean, you mentioned Lockerbie, people immediately say, so there's that factor as well.
Very nice town to bring up a family. I certainly have found that, and it's a very friendly town. And it's returned to that. I think, obviously, it's a very fluid population, so lots of people have moved away since the disaster. And it's not talked about much at all. And I have to say, there is resentment in the town up to the media intrusion that will occur on the 25th anniversary. It was the same at the 10th anniversary and the 20th. People just want to be left alone. But on the other hand, having been a local councillor for 12 years, I do know that it's not just our town. This disaster belonged to the... it was national and international.
Lockerbie, we've all moved on since 1988 because you've got a choice. You move on, you re-establish your life. I enjoy my life. I do enjoy my life. I'm still very much involved with Lockerbie, with the Americans and all that, but you've got to move on, you've got to make a choice.
100 years from now, there will be nobody alive who had anything to do with it. I've no doubt the memorial will be there as a permanent mark of respect for those who died. The memorial window in the town hall will be there, and various other local memorials. But it will be something in the past. It certainly has brought Lockerbie to world attention in a way that had never been the case before. But life will move on.